This is one of the most visited holy places in the world, the jewel in Poland's crown, the Jasna Góra Monastery, known as the Hill of Light. Every year, 4 million worshipers from all over the world come here to gather and implore the Black Madonna of Częstochowa in a peaceful and prayerful atmosphere. But when night falls, in the streets around the monastery, ultra-nationalist groups have taken over the area. Standing together with flaming torches and dark clothing, 500 members of the all-Polish youth repeat far-right slogans. Twenty-three-year-old Marcin is a prominent champion of All Polish Youth, an organization who advocate for a vision of Poland which is white, Catholic, and openly homophobic.
Wyrzuca te czyny człowieka, wyrzucają z tego kościoła, a nie to, jaki jest. Jeżeli ktoś jest niepraktykujący i nie dokonuje takich czynów, no to może być, nie? I tyle. I w kościele, i tutaj, nie? Ale też wtedy nie ma potrzeby podkreślania tego, że jest homoseksualistą. Nie? Tak, dlatego z tym walczymy. I walczymy z propagowaniem tego.
Every year at Pentecost, the All Polish Youth organize this rally at the Jasna Góra Monastery with the complicity of the religious authorities. The clergy have provided them with a crypt inside the holy site for an important ceremony, the induction of new members. But before they join the group, they must first immerse themselves in its ideology.
Ta książka to jest książka Romana Dmowskiego, czyli jednego z trzech ojców niepodległości. Tak jak wcześniej mówiłem, no mamy kanon lektur, no i na przykład ta książka jest w tym kanonie lektur, który kandydat musi zaliczyć. Ale no tak, my jako uważamy się za spadkobierców tej idei narodowej.
The new recruits must be well versed in the works of Adam Dobosinski, a notoriously anti-Semitic writer. He is known to have been responsible for looting Jewish-owned businesses in the 1930s. Several distinguished guests have come to this event to support the All Polish Youth, including the former deputy bishop of Jasna Góra.
Dlatego, że stanowicie wspólnotę, o której można powiedzieć, cytując świętego Jana Pawła II.
And Robert Winicki, a member of parliament who believes that Poland is caught in the middle between two enemies.
Dzisiaj oczywiście musimy na powrót uczynić nasze państwo silnym militarnie, bo jest zagrożenie ze strony Moskwy, ze wschodu. Kulturowo, bo jest zagrożenie.
Today, five young people are joining the 3,000 members of this movement. Around 50,000 people in Poland support the extreme right ultra-nationalist movement. And their hateful rhetoric seems to resonate in a country which is in the midst of an identity crisis. Poland, in Eastern Europe, with a population of 38 million people, lies at the heart of a particularly unstable region. Poland shares a border with Ukraine and also a 190-kilometer border with Belarus, a country which is allied with Vladimir Putin. Faced with the threat from Russia, Poland is now the first line of defense for NATO. The country has even set itself the goal of doubling the size of its army to become Europe's leading army within 10 years. But while Poland has been praised for its decisive role in the war in Ukraine, it has also been criticized for its domestic policy since the Law and Justice Party came to power in 2015. President Andrzej Duda's policies are nationalist and conservative. He has gone up against the European Union, refusing to conform to environmental standards, and supports the coal mining industry.
Jasną sprawą jest i oczywistą, że węgiel jest naszym absolutnie podstawowym surowcem energetycznym.
There are 60,000 coal miners in Poland, and every day they descend 650 meters below the surface of the earth, at risk to their lives.
Szczęść Boże.
Poland is Europe's leading producer of combustible fuel, but also one of the most polluted countries in Europe. In some regions, the air has become toxic. In the town of Rybnik, children suffer from severe respiratory illnesses throughout the winter.
I ten kaszel nie ustawał. Był bardzo męczący, dziecko płakało, nie potrafiło złapać powietrza.
Poland is not only the black sheep on the environment, but also when it comes to civil liberties. The government is behind on women's rights. Along with Malta, Poland is the last country in the European Union to still ban abortion.
Abortion itself is probably the largest genocidal act that is being committed now on the world.
As a result of this, 80,000 women per year have secret abortions. Justyna faces a 3-year prison sentence for having sent abortion pills to another woman.
I think this is the direction to shut us down.
Under government influence, homophobic hate speech is on the rise, but a large number of young people are rising up and refuse this relapse back into conservatism.
People telling me, oh, go to the West if you like it so much. You have all rights over there. No, I want to fight here.
Poland is more divided than ever before, between those who defend traditional values and those who want Poland to modernize and look to the future. In the southwest of Poland, in Silesia, a deeply Catholic area, the local economy depends on coal. They have been mining coal here for the past 2 centuries. And coal mining still employs around 80,000 people. 20 working mines dot the landscape of Silesia. They are the pride of the region. But following pressure from the European Union, the government has committed to closing the mines. In the meantime, the mine at Zimovit still produces 3 million tons of coal per year. Michal, one of the 7,000 workers at the mine. He is 33 years old and has worked here since the age of 19. A few minutes before he descends deep below the surface, Michal, a devout Catholic, prays for protection to Saint Barbara, the patron saint of miners.
Dwa, trzy słowa, proszę o to, żeby zazwyczaj mówimy tak, żeby życzymy sobie, żeby ile było zjazdu, tyle wyjazdów. Ja myślę, że tak każda osoba pracująca zjeżdżająca na dół w tym kierunku idzie.
Michal is the foreman and responsible for the safety of 25 men. It is a huge responsibility.
Z punktu mojego widzenia oczywiście, jako osoby dozoru, już mniej więcej człowiek już myśli, co trzeba wykonać, jak z tymi ludźmi porozmawiać, jak ich podzielić, żeby wykonali tą pracę przede wszystkim bezpiecznie i efektywnie. No to, co na wszystkim nam zależy. Cześć Boże. Witam Cię. Jak taką ładną Pani? Najładniejsze na lępowni. My no, wybieramy te najładniejsze.
Dziękuję bardzo.
Dziękuję bardzo
Pani. Wyślę. Takie macie.
301 proszę zapisać.
Before descending 650 meters underground, they remember the fate of 15 miners who died in 2022 in nearby coal mines. Production never stops, so the teams work shifts around the clock. For the next 8 hours, Michal will be deep in the bowels of the earth with no contact with the world above. First of all, they take the lift, which takes them down 500 meters below the surface. But there is still a long way to go before they reach the coal face. The miners need to travel another 160 kilometers of underground tunnels by the pit railway.
Najchudszy
to pasuje.
No, pasuje.
Four of them squeeze into 1 square meter for a 45-minute journey. So to pass the time, they talk about their working conditions.
Mówię, no to oni mają 3 razy droższy węgiel, no to o czym my tu rozmawiamy?
My tam byliśmy na taki strajk, bo tam jest ogólnie uzwiązkowienie, tam jest ogólnie takie, że tam wszystko przez Solidarność załatwia.
The mine's resources are depleted over time, so the miners dig ever deeper, explore ever further. Deep in these underground tunnels, they are highly vulnerable if there is an accident. The coal dust is highly flammable, and to cope with the dust, they use oxygen masks.
Na urządzenie, tak zwany aparat ucieczkowy, składa się przede wszystkim masy tlenotwórczej, która w przypadku poruszania się, czyli podążania drogą ucieczkową, wystarczy nam gdzieś tam na te 60 minut.
Michal supervises the extraction of the coal, but he knows that his future is under threat. Following pressure from the European Union, Poland has committed to closing all of its mines by 2049. And Michal is angry about it.
No to górnicy, którzy tu ciężko pracują, nieraz pracą na tym zdrowie, to po prostu źli na to, źli. A mówiąc, po prostu, bo górnicy wkurwieni są po prostu, bo oni poświęcają swój czas, swoje zdrowie, bo to nie jest łatwa praca w takich warunkach. A ktoś tam na Brukseli, siedzący za przeproszeniem w krawatach, mówi: nie, wasz polski węgiel jest zły.
For the moment, they will continue to mine fuel thanks to this coal shearer, which cuts away the coal face. It's a steel monster, 3.5 meters high. But today, it is failing to start.
Zaprawić to czy
jeszcze nie wiemy, czy nie ma komunikatu.
Moje sygnał, tylko żebyśmy się odsunęli, żeby nie dostali.
Tego zrobione tam jest.
Może wyjść nie ze ściany, może wyjdą tamte na kolana.
Oni się przydarzą.
After a few technical modifications, production can start again. Coal gushes out of the machine, and a thick cloud of dust covers the miners.
Mamy tu nasze czarne złoto. Jest to nasz skarb narodowy, który traktujemy jako cenny surowiec, który umożliwia nam przede wszystkim bezpieczeństwo energetyczne. Dzięki temu ludzie w Polsce, myślę, że mogą spać spokojnie ze względu na zabezpieczenie potrzeb energetycznych naszego kraju.
Once the machine starts work, the miners need to ensure the transport of the coal on these conveyor belts. They extract 700 tons of coal per shift. After more than 8 hours of hard work in the difficult, dusty, humid conditions, Michal can finally return to the surface. 10% of people in the town work at the mine like Michal. The foreman earns 1,700 euros per month, which is 3 times the minimum wage in Poland. The salary provides a comfortable lifestyle for him and his family. Michal has 2 young children, Leon and Bianca. His wife's parents have come over to share a traditional Silesian meal.
Michał, zapraszam, posmakujesz jeszcze tej kapusty. Górnicy muszą mieć mięso, żeby mieć energię i siłę.
This is a coal mining family going back for generations. Sylvester, Michal's father-in-law, spent 25 years working underground as a coal miner. He's 49 years old and already retired, a benefit reserved for miners.
Mamka, dziadek to tak mieszkał blisko kopalni, wiesz? I kiedyś wyjechałem z domu i nie poszedłem na łaźnię się umyć i cały czarny przyszedłem do domu. Babcia myślała, że jakiś diabeł przyszedł.
Z górników poznać? Że mają niedomyte oczy.
No, zawsze miałem takie
jest tak?
pomalowane oczy.
Jest tak, że tata przyjeżdżał niekiedy z niedomytymi oczami.
Skoczę się pod te talerzyki.
Sylvester keeps treasured memories in this photo album. He is a little nostalgic for this bygone era.
Widzisz, jak dziadek? Taką lampę miał na głowie tutaj.
Tak przypominam te zdjęcia, no to bardzo fajne czasy. I elegancko by. Dawniej mi się zdaje, że lepiej. Teraz jest gonitwa za węglem i wszystko, no na hura, na hura, na hura. A wtedy się szło, naszych te swoje się zrobiło. Na piwko i do domu. Mieli węgiel i ciepło.
Sylvester is counting on his grandson to continue the family tradition.
Dobre, dobre, nie?
Chyba, że jeszcze wnuk będzie.
Tak, mama. Święta Barbara musi trzymać w opiece. Dokładnie. Patronka górników.
The family are devout Catholics and they go to Mass every Sunday. 90% of Polish people are baptized, which is the highest rate anywhere in Europe. Under communism, which lasted from 1952 to 1989, Pope John Paul II and the priesthood played a decisive role as dissidents in the face of repression by the communist regime. So, for many Polish people, the Catholic Church is a source of national strength. This little village church is full every Sunday. Some people have to follow the Mass from outside.
Też się staramy jednak taką tradycję dzieciom przekazać i żeby mieli to też w nawyku, żeby chodzić do tego kościółka, pomodlić się. Czasami to może też coś pomoże, nie? Raneczka na przykład przed snem zawsze ma taką swoją tradycję, że się zawsze pomodlisz Aniele Boże i to zawsze ci też pomaga, nie?
Catholic values and traditions also include remembering the dead. Michal and his family pray for those who lost their lives in the mine, like Lucas.
No, znaliśmy się gdzieś tam z grów, tak mówię, trenowaliśmy razem w piłkę nożną, graliśmy gdzieś tam, mieliśmy wspólne jakieś wyjazdy takie integracyjne i tym podobne.
Lucas died at the age of 33. His tomb bears the insignia of a miner.
On pracował na kopalni Wesoła, na oddziale wydobywczym. Zawalił się nad nim strop. Znaleziono go dwa dni później, po prowadzeniu akcji ratowniczej, zgniecionego praktycznie na pół, gdzie głowę miał między kolanami.
Despite the risks of his profession, Michal wants his region's mining tradition to continue. But while coal mining might protect Poland's energy independence, the indiscriminate use of coal has a devastating impact on the environment and public health. Poland suffers exceptionally high levels of pollution. Of the 50 most polluted towns in Europe, 22 of them are located in Poland. The city of Rybnik lies 40 kilometers from the Zimowit mine. From the beginning of winter, the air becomes unbreathable. As soon as the coal stoves are lit to heat the homes, a thick fog blankets the city. Katarzyna is a doctor. Every day she checks the air pollution. And as usual, the levels are well above the World Health Organization's recommended limits.
Te wykresy mówią nam, że stężenie pyłów o średnicy 2,5 mikrometra i 10 mikrometrów jest przekroczone. No akurat tego pyłu 2,5 o 350%. Bardzo niebezpieczne i mniejsze cząstki, tym bardziej niebezpieczne, bo głębiej penetrują do naszego organizmu i właściwie docierają do każdej komórki naszego ciała, czyniąc tam spustoszenie.
Katarzyna leads the pediatric medicine service at the hospital in Rybnik. Winter has just begun and all 30 beds are occupied.
A my gości, gości.
Co się teraz dzieje? Wystraszona, chodźcie jeszcze brzuszko.
pięknie.
All her patients are suffering from similar problems.
Zauważam taki kaszel mocniejszy się zrobił, taki mokry i taki duszący.
Także się zaczęła dusić troszkę, tak?
Tak.
Polish children are exposed to 4 times as much pollution as children in other European countries like France.
Buziaczka szeroko otwórz. Jeśli jest zanieczyszczenie powietrza, przyspiesza oddech, no łapie to powietrze i wtedy musimy lekami te oskrzela rozszerzyć, żeby to powietrze do płuc się mogło dostać.
Jagodka was brought to the hospital by her mother as an emergency 1 week ago. She is suffering from pneumonia.
Jeszcze jest dużo zmian. Jeszcze świsty, taki wydłużony wydech, rzężenie.
No wyglądało to tak, że dziecko w środku nocy zaczęło kaszleć i ten kaszel nie ustawał. Był bardzo męczący, dziecko płakało, nie potrafiło złapać powietrza.
Bardzo się pani bała, Jagoda.
Tak, tak. Miałam najczarniejsze myśli tak naprawdę.
Jagodka is only 4 years old, but this is the 3rd time that she has been hospitalized. 45,000 people a year die in Poland because of atmospheric pollution, twice the proportion that die in France, for example. The doctor believes that there is only one solution. They must stop using coal.
Jestem rodowitą Ślązaczką. Jestem dumna z tego, że tutaj mieszkam, że tutaj pracuję, kocham to tradycję, a Śląsk to węgiel, Śląsk to kopalnie. Natomiast uważam, że te dwie sprawy niestety trzeba rozdzielić. Epoka palenia węglem kamiennym powinna się zakończyć, bo jest to po prostu szkodliwe dla naszego zdrowia, dla zdrowia nas i naszych dzieci. Dlatego tutaj nie ma miejsca na sentymenty, nie ma miejsca po prostu na utrwalanie pewnych złych zachowań.
Fine particle pollution is mainly caused by domestic heating. The regional authorities have started to address the issue, albeit cautiously. They have banned the use of coal-fired stoves manufactured before 2007, which have no filter and are highly polluting. In Pěšina, the city police are on the hunt. Today, Piotr and Wojciech are going to smoke out the illegal stoves. They test about a dozen every day based on tip-offs from local residents.
Jeżeli rozpoczyna się sezon, zwiększa się ilość kontroli. Zresztą ludzie sami już od siebie, że tak powiem, dbają o środowisko, patrzą, kto pali.
Dzień dobry. Straż Miejska Pszczyna, grunt Wojciech. Chcielibyśmy zobaczyć kotłownię.
Nie. Nawet się pies przeciwko nam sprzysiągł.
Dobra.
Przepraszam bardzo, mamy taki przypadek.
The stove is in the basement. If it does not comply with regulations, the owner faces a fine of 1,000 euros.
Za nowy piec?
No, już jest 3 lata.
3 lata, ja?
No.
Klasy, tutaj mamy tabliczkę znamionową. Tu mają państwo klasę piątą. Klasa piąta. Tu macie rok produkcji 2012. Piec jest nowy.
No.
Także najwyższej klasy.
Despite these checks, many Polish people are obliged to break the law.
A teraz sprawy wczorajszego zgłoszenia. Co ma wpływ na smog? Ze względu na to, że finanse kogoś mogą nie puszczać do tego, zdarzają się, że po prostu utrzymają stare piece na wymianę takiego pieca. Wymiana teraz takiego pieca razem z montażem to jest gdzieś do 20 tysięcy złotych.
3.5 million people are currently using old, highly polluting stoves because they can't afford to change them. Danuta and her husband Adam live in Nowy Janów, in the center of Poland.
Może Krystianka zawoła, niech weźmie tego psa.
They can see the coal-fired power station at Belchatów from their garden. It produces more pollution than any other power station in Europe.
fajnie to swoje podwórko, kwiatek rośnie, miło, przyjemnie jest, no jest bardzo fajnie. Ogarnąć, bo taka troszeczkę pogoda dopisała, no i trzeba to wykorzystać.
Adam and Danuta are getting ready for winter. The temperature drops as low as minus 15 degrees centigrade in this region of Poland. Their home is heated with coal, just like 50% of people in Poland.
Tu tak, tu się wkłada, tutaj przelatuje ten opał. Tu o, ogień jest, żar z tego opału. Tutaj mamy popiół. W dzień jednak człowiek albo idzie do pracy, a jak jest w domu, no to wiadomo, że dorzuci, tak?
Adam and Danuta worry about the phasing out of coal. Since the war in Ukraine began, the price of coal has skyrocketed and their stock is running out.
To już taki naprawdę bardzo drobny węgiel, bo to już są, mówię.
So the couple burn everything they can, including plastic waste, at obvious risk to their health.
I tyle wie pan, no było 70 coś kopalni w Polsce, a zostało, o ile dobrze pamiętam, 17. No to są ludzie pozbawione pracy, ludzie pozbawieni ciepła, tak?
Adam is a retired truck driver and Danuta doesn't work. So, to save money, they keep a few winter provisions in a very well hidden spot.
Papryka z buraczkami, buraczki, ogórki, fasolka.
To są akurat grzybki tegoroczne, zalewę. I wykorzystujemy je do obiadu, do ziemniaków.
Poland plans to end its dependence on coal and comply with European Union environmental regulations. And so it has decided to focus on nuclear power. However, the first nuclear power plant will not be operational until 2033. In the meantime, the government has once again authorized the use of lignite for domestic heating. It is cheaper than normal coal, but it is the most harmful type of coal to human health. Poland is the black sheep of the European Union on the environment, but it is also criticized by other European countries for its stance on civil liberties. Along with Malta, it is the last country in Europe where abortion is still illegal. In 2020, it was even banned in cases of fetal impairment. It is now only permitted in cases of rape or immediate danger to the mother's life. Pro and anti-abortion campaigners clash over this issue, and one news item has divided society. In front of the courthouse in Warsaw, hundreds of people have come onto the street to denounce a trial which they see as a fresh attack on women's rights. But a few meters away from them, fundamentalist Catholic organizations are also demonstrating. Photos of bloody fetuses, anti-abortion slogans, their goal is to be just as visible as the opposing camp.
30,000 dzieci. Tyle każdego roku jest zabijanych w Polsce przez własne matki za pomocą pigułek aborcyjnych.
Aborcja jest morderstwem, jest zabójstwem ze szczególnym okrucieństwem i domagamy się ogólnie karania dzieciom
płciowym.
This is a high-profile trial. Justyna Wydrinska, a mother of three children aged 48, is facing a three-year prison sentence for having helped a woman who wanted an abortion. Justyna is a pro-abortion militant. A few months ago, she was put in touch with a desperate young woman who wanted to end her pregnancy. Justyna sent her abortion pills through the post.
It was totally a stranger person for me. I just have heard a story that she's living with an abusive partner, with the violence. I knew exactly what she was going through because it was also my own experience. So I put this very small envelope inside the box and closed it and went home.
2 days later, the woman's husband called the police, who traced the pills back to Justyna. Her apartment was searched and a prosecution was launched against her.
You cannot imagine what sending abortion pills can go like in 3 years in jail.
Justyna has been fighting for the legalization of abortion in Poland for 15 years. she is at the premises of her association Abortion Dream Team with her friends Natalia and Kinga. Every day, they receive around 40 calls from women asking for their help.
3 p.m., I think, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16,
Cześć, chodź.
Today, her lawyer has come over for a final review of her case before the trial.
Jesteś gotowy na proces swojego życia?
Jestem.
Sprawa stulecia aborcyjna.
Above all, it is Justyna's activism that is being put on trial.
Oczywiście Justyna jest aktywistką, to nadaje tej sprawie zupełną inną rangę niż pojedynczej osoby, bo na pewno związana jest tu pewna otoczka polityczna.
In the charges, the prosecutor wrote that I am abortion activist and I work in abortion dream team and I share information about how to do safe medical abortion in Poland. So this is why I think that this is from the very beginning, it's very political.
Justyna is facing an influential adversary. In the center of Warsaw, other lawyers are also preparing for the hearing. They are members of Ordo Iuris, a well-established ultra-conservative lobby that is very close to the political powers that be in Poland. Jerzy Kwasniewski is the president of Ordo Iuris.
A jak to się w ogóle skończyło? To dziecko w końcu zostało poronione, prawda?
Tak. Ordo Iuris was admitted as counsel to the court for Justyna's trial.
The aim of this abortion was to kill the child. We have asked for this special status because the interest of the child has no representative in proceeding.
Ordo Iuris wants to roll abortion rights back even further. They want to ban abortion even in cases of rape.
Dzień dobry jeszcze raz w takim razie. Dzień dobry. It should be forbidden as all other ways of killing people. Abortion itself is probably the largest genocidal act that is being committed now on the world, in the world. This mass abortion process that is going on globally has already killed tens of millions of people.
Funded by private donations to the tune of 2 million euros a year and with the help of an army of lawyers, Ordo Iuris lobbies the government on family values. They even want to ban divorce, and in order to achieve their aims, they have gone on the offensive.
It is our aim to influence not only academia, not only the legal professionals, but also the public opinion. And through the public opinion, we need to influence the politicians, we need to influence the culture, we need to influence the social processes.
Ordo Iuris's methods are effective. Its members have risen to the highest levels in the state. In 2019, the founder, Aleksander Stepkowski, was nominated as a judge in the Constitutional Court by the Polish president. And 1 year later, along with other judges, the court banned abortion in cases of fetal impairment.
Oraz uzależniają ochronę prawa do życia dziecka jeszcze nieurodzonego od jego stanu zdrowia, co stanowi zakazaną bezpośrednią dyskryminację oraz...
The decision of the Constitutional Court in Poland was a success of Ordo Iuris and our friends from different NGOs, organizations and politicians who are siding with this perspective.
To recruit future jurists to their fundamentalist values, in 2021, Ordo Iuris started a university of law.
Mr. Prime Minister, Your Magnificency, Mr. Rector, all the professors...
The Europe of the third millennium will either be Christian or will not be at all. That's why we're creating Collegium Intermarium.
As an advisor to the court, Jerzy Kwasniewski wants to use Justyna's trial to promote his ideas. For the first time in Europe, a pro-abortion activist is on trial in Warsaw for helping a woman who wanted an abortion.
It
it's heartbreaking to not be there and scream and but sitting in a in its room and listen to those shitty things sometimes. The support I hear, and I hope the support I will be here from the courtroom, it gives me a lot of like strength, really.
Dzień dobry, proszę Państwa, otwieram rozprawę w sprawie Filipa 18/20. To będzie rozpoznawana sprawa oskarżonej.
In the courtroom, Jerzy Kwaśniewski, the president of Ordo Iuris, takes a prominent position right next to the prosecutor.
Jerzy Kwaśniewski, składam upoważnienie, Wysoki Sądzie.
Jerzy Kwaśniewski.
Na prezentacji.
Justyna has to answer the judge's questions.
I oskarżoną proszę o powstanie. Miała Pani bezpośredni kontakt z osobą, do której te tabletki zostały wysłane?
Nie, nie miałam kontaktu.
Nie miałam. Żadnego. Ani mailowego, ani telefonicznego?
Nie.
Bardzo Pani dziękuję, Pani Pani.
But within a quarter of an hour, there is a dramatic turn of events.
Odroczenie lub przerwanie rozprawy i ponowne wezwanie.
The trial is postponed. The man who filed the complaint against Justyna, the husband of the woman who took the abortion pill, has not come to the hearing. Justyna will face another trial in 3 months.
Jestem zła, że ta sprawa się ci nie odbyła. To jest trochę strata mojego czasu, bo w tej chwili mogłabym odbierać telefon i wspierać osoby w aborcjach, a muszę być tu.
This is the second time that the witness has failed to come forward and the trial has been adjourned.
Every time I have to come here, it costs me more. I think this is the direction to shut us down, to close our mouth, to not support people because of the fear. We should feel. I not feel any fear. Because of this. I know what I'm doing and I know that this is the right what I should do.
Outside the courthouse, Justyna has to face another ordeal. The anti-abortion activists don't hesitate to use shock tactics to undermine her. They broadcast the cries of newborn babies.
For me, I try to not like think that they are here, like they are existing, because it's for me it's a waste of energy to focus on them, really.
In March 2023, Justyna was finally sentenced to 8 months of community service. She is appealing the verdict. Long before this sensational trial, in 2021, thousands of people came into the streets to protest. Isabella, a 30-year-old young woman, had just died following the refusal of her doctors to end her high-risk pregnancy. Her sister-in-law, Barbara, based in Pishina in the south of Poland, remembers the evening that Isabella was admitted to hospital.
21 września Izabela się zgłosiła do szpitala w Pszczynie. No niestety w tym szpitalu nie udzielono jej właściwej...
Isabella was 5.5 months pregnant when her waters broke prematurely. The fetus was suffering from a rare illness incompatible with life. But the doctors were afraid of being prosecuted if they performed an abortion, as they would risk 3 years in prison. So they waited for the fetus's heart to stop before intervening.
Byliśmy w kontakcie z Izą do godziny 23. Izabela pisała do nas tak. Nie mogą dać, muszą czekać, aż się samo zacznie, a jak nie, to czekamy, aż serce przestanie bić. Ale wody odeszły, że takie mają procedury.
Isabella's condition quickly deteriorated. 2 hours after the fetus's death, she succumbed to septic shock.
Zarówno i politycy, jak również lekarze są współwinni śmierci Izabeli.
Isabella had opened her own hairdressers 5 years before her death.
Cześć, ale nie chcę słuchać. Wszystko dobrze?
Tak.
Marzyła o otwarciu tego salonu. Spędzała tu bardzo dużą część swojego czasu. Bardzo kochała swoją pracę i to była jej zarówno nie tylko praca, jakże i pasja.
Isabella was 30 years old when she died. She left behind a husband and a 9-year-old daughter called Maya.
One były jak przyjaciółki tutaj, tak samo na lotnisku. Ona ma mnóstwo zdjęć właśnie z podróży, bo bardzo często podróżowali ze względu na to, że Iza chciała jej pokazywać świat, jak wygląda.
Barbara and her family have filed a complaint against the doctors for manslaughter. They are awaiting trial. Civil liberties have been under threat since the Law and Justice Party came to power in 2015. Poland's leader Andrzej Duda wants to promote his ultra-conservative vision everywhere, even in schools.
A coś jeszcze dostanę do podpisu? Czy tylko tyle?
Barbara Nowak is the head of the District Education Office. She oversees 4,900 state schools.
A czym się zajmujemy? No zajmujemy się przede wszystkim nadzorem pedagogicznym. Patrzymy, czy szkoły dobrze funkcjonują, czy w szkołach są zatrudnieni nauczyciele z kwalifikacjami, czy uczniowie są bezpieczni, jakie realizują programy.
Catholic symbols are visible everywhere in her office. This is despite the fact that in Poland, religion and state are officially separated. Barbara Nowak is in charge of overseeing the teaching of a new subject in secondary schools, dealing with the history of Poland since the end of the Second World War.
To jest książka Historia i teraźniejszość, nowy zupełnie przedmiot w naszych szkołach. Po to wprowadzony, żeby młodzi Polacy znali swoje losy, zwłaszcza te najnowsze.
The textbook was written by a member of the ruling party. Inside, we find a passage about France and one of its icons, Brigitte Bardot.
Od lat 60. XX wieku rewolucja seksualna podkopywała także fundamenty życia rodzinnego na Zachodzie. Z czasem codzienną praktyką stały się rozwody i współżycie bez zobowiązań. Nigdzie tak skutecznie jak w rodzinie człowiek nie uczy się życia. Na mniej lub bardziej trwałym fundamencie można przyswajać sobie wiedzę o świecie. To jest takie podsumowanie właściwie bardzo pasujące do dnia dzisiejszego w Polsce. Ale tak, oczywiście, ja uważam, że w bardzo złym kierunku idzie model społeczny na Zachodzie. To znaczy takie zaniedbanie swoich obowiązków społecznych, obywatelskich wobec państwa. Jeżeli mówimy o odtwarzaniu pokoleń, to rzecz jest oczywista.
Bardzo dużo wywalić tą potrzebę.
Barbara Nowak's words sometimes target a very specific community.
Zatem absolutnie nie popieram i nie pochwalam tej takiej agresywnej postawy środowiska LGBT, które wymuszają afirmacje, wymuszają przywileje, co do których po prostu nie mają prawa. Ale to jest kwestia cywilizacyjna. My jesteśmy w cywilizacji chrześcijańskiej. Model rodziny nie jest czymś, nad czym się dyskutuje. Model rodziny jest oczywisty. To jest mężczyzna, kobieta, dzieci.
It has become more and more common to hear opinions like this in Poland. Since the election of Andrzej Duda, homophobic hate speech is on the rise. During his 2020 election campaign, he compared the LGBT community to an old enemy, communism.
Że to, że próbowano w szkołach dzieciom przez cały okres komunizmu wciskać komunistyczną ideologię, dzisiaj też próbuje nam się i naszym dzieciom wciskać ideologię, tylko inną. Zupełnie nową, aczkolwiek to też jest taki neobolszewizm.
These homophobic attacks are not considered criminal offenses in Poland and are even amplified by the public television channel TVP. In 2019, it broadcast a report about the LGBT community, which was watched by millions of people. The community was portrayed as a threat to Polish identity. The title of the report was Invasion.
To, co ja sobie nazywam właśnie religią obecnie dominującą w Europie Zachodniej.
Wie pan, co widzę? Widzę kolorową tęczę ognia nad Sodomą I Gomorą.
For 25 minutes, the speakers made one openly homophobic and stigmatizing statement after another. The LGBT community is even accused of promoting pedophilia.
Pojawiają się organizacje, które coraz śmielej domagają się, by za normę uznać pedofilię.
These allegations are unsubstantiated. In 2020, the courts ordered TVP to remove this offensive documentary from YouTube.
Tramwajem wodnym, to się tramwaj wodny nazywa.
One man in particular was targeted by this propaganda. He lives in Warsaw.
Ładne słońce jest w ogóle.
No. Czy możemy w tą stronę zrobić? O. We love Warsaw. We are living here for 10 years right now. I cannot imagine to live in any other place in the world. They will not make me change it. And I mean, the strange people telling me, oh, go to the West if you like it so much. You have all rights over there. No, I want to fight for it here.
Bart Staszewski is an LGBT activist. He has just moved into this apartment with his partner, Svalek.
I forgot about those things. I don't even knew that I have it. All of those stuff is lying on the floor or in the boxes because we don't have furniture for it. We don't know where is everything. We just...
Bart was forced to move because he feared for his safety.
My address was known for some of the right-wing activists. For different reasons and different occasions during my lifetime, they could see it easily. So now I'm much more secure.
Bart became well known 3 years ago. 100 or so local authorities had signed anti-LGBT charters. Bart denounced them in his videos by putting up signs designed to shock.
Cześć, tutaj Bart Staszewski, jestem z moim znakiem, strefa wolna od LGBT. Jestem w siedzibie powiatu, który się taką strefą ogłosił, więc stawiam swój znak I robię zdjęcie. Zobaczcie, jak to wygląda w praktyce.
His videos went viral and made him a thorn in the side of public television. Within a month, his name had been mentioned in 134 damning reports broadcast in prime time.
Nie brak opinii, że to początek ideologicznej skrajnie lewicowej ofensywy, która ma atakować tradycyjne polskie wartości.
So it was day after the day, from the morning to the evening, they was creating me as an enemy of Poland, which is lying, which is against Poland, and I should be punished somehow. It's the worst propaganda tool I have ever seen in the hands of the government, which is using this obviously against the people they don't like.
As a result of this smear campaign, Bart received a torrent of hatred on social media.
My boyfriend make a list of them, so we see that there are quite a lot just from 1 month that we collected.
He receives 100 threatening messages a month.
Bartie Staszewski, zamorduje cię skurwielu, rozjebie ci łeb siekierą. Wiem, gdzie mieszkasz I obserwuję twoją drogę do domu. You are just a garbage and a horrible liar. Kurwo, ludobójcy, gestapowcy, bandyci, terroryści, tym jest wasza nazistowska ideologia. So it's hurt me a lot thinking about that. Now somebody is comparing me to Hitler, Germany, soldiers, that I am some kind of Nazi. It's horrible, but the only thing that I can do is make a compliment on Facebook, and usually it's not working.
Now that his face is widely recognized, he has to be even more vigilant.
It's quite dangerous. Mm. We feel somebody could recognize him, and it would be different reaction, not positive.
For many Polish people, this decline in women's rights and LGBT rights is not just due to the government. They also blame the influence of the Catholic Church. The institution is controversial due to its stand against abortion, and religious practice is declining. In 2001, 50% of Polish people attended Sunday Mass. Today, the number is closer to 28%, especially in large cities. Krakow, for example, has a population of 800,000. Paula is the mother of a little girl, Maya. Paula is a student of psychology and lives in Krakow.
So wherever I live all around the world, I always go back here. That's home for me. That's the place which defines me, reminds me who I am.
But over the past 7 years, she hardly recognizes her own country.
It's not a private sphere for keeping at home. It's everywhere around us. Maybe in very, very Islamic places of the world, religion mixed with politics and culture as much as here.
The church's interference in public life has led to widespread distrust. Since the conservatives came to power in 2015, positive opinion of the church has fallen from 62% to 41% of society. Maya was not baptized, unlike Paula, who is still part of the church, but not for long, because in a few hours, Paula will be an apostate, the definitive annulment of her baptism. Her best friend has come to support her.
Zobacz, stworzyłam takie dzieło. Przeczytaj i zobaczycie, przekonuję.
Oświadczenie woli. Na podstawie artykułu bla bla bla.
Majeczko, Majo, nie lej.
W sprawie wstąpienia,
wytrzyj to teraz.
Powrotu do wspólnoty Kościoła uchwalonego 7 października i tak dalej. Jednocześnie na podstawie strasznie dużo tych dekretów.
Tak. Trzeba się zabezpieczyć.
To leave the Catholic Church, Paula first had to obtain her baptismal certificate from the parish where she was baptized. Then she had to give her reasons for doing so in writing.
Na ocenę składa się pobłażliwe podejście do problemu pedofilii wśród duchownych, pogardliwy język w stosunku do mniejszości seksualnych, stosunek Kościoła do praw kobiet.
Paula could simply have stopped going to church, but she wanted to be totally, officially expelled.
Niesamowite, nie? Wypisała z bycia Polakiem.
No nie? Jejku.
Very, very proud of Paula. And I wish I could do it myself, but my family reason won't let me do it. They meet in church, they talk about church and so that's the part of life in small villages. That's why church is so strong.
There are no official figures for the extent of apostasy in Poland. The church keeps them secret, even though it recognizes the issue.
Okay.
But according to several groups on social media, it affects tens of thousands of people, especially since the new law on abortion. Paula has to justify herself to the priest for half an hour.
How did it go?
I was consequent with my actions from A to Z. I wanted to leave, and finally I left, so I feel relieved.
This document confirming her official departure from the church is signed by her parish priest. Here's everything that she is now forbidden to do.
Which is stating that I won't be able to work for the church. I won't be able to be a part of the any kind of associations and organizations connected with the church, and I won't have a Catholic funeral.
More and more Polish people like Paula are opposed to the church and the government's conservatism. According to recent polling, the Law and Justice Party could even lose its majority at the next elections in 2023.